Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. We are discussing on the Module 10, Cyclometric Properties and Cyclometric Processes. So this is the 7th lecture on cyclometrics. So we recap from the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we studied about the cyclometric properties and cyclometric chart. So, using the cyclometric chart, we can take all the cyclometric properties like dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, dew point temperature, specific humidity, relative humidity, enthalpy of air water vapor mixture, and then the specific volume of the air. And we studied about the cyclometric processes like sensible heating, sensible cooling, cooling dehumidification, heating, humidification, adiabatic mixing of air streams, and we solved a few problems in the previous lectures. Now we continue with the problem in this lecture. So the topic here is problem in cyclometric process and the properties, and the learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem on the cyclometric process and cyclometric properties. And we take the example number 21. The 1 kg of air at 40 degree dry bulb temperature and 50% relative humidity is mixed with 2 kg of air at 20 degree dry bulb temperature and 20 degree dew point temperature. Calculate the temperature and specific humidity of the mixture. So, this is the problem on adiabatic mixing. So, the given data G1, mass of the air for the first duct 1 kilogram, G2, mass of the air in the second duct 2 kg, inlet condition T1 equal to 40 degree Celsius and Phi1 equal to 50% relative humidity. For the second pipe, T2 equal to temperature is 20 degree Celsius and dew point temperature is 20 degree Celsius. Now, using the cyclometric chart, we solve the problem. So, first we fix the initial condition T1 equal to, so this is the initial condition T1 equal to 40 degree Celsius and Phi1 equal to 50%. So, 40 degree Celsius and 50% relative humidity, this is point 1. And T2, second condition, T2 equal to 20 degree Celsius, dry bulb temperature 20 degree Celsius and dew point temperature 20 degree Celsius, this is the point number 2. So, you connect 1 and 2. We connect 1 and 2 and we take the, we note down the properties now. So, we take the properties H1 equal to 101 kilojoules per kilogram, H2 equal to 60 kilojoules per kilogram, W1 equal to 24 grams per kg and W2 equal to 15.5 grams per kg. So, W1 this is 24 grams per kg, W2 this is 15.5 grams per kg, H1 is this is 101 kilojoules per kilogram and here it is 60 kilojoules per kilogram. So, we have taken all the properties. Now, we go up to the next slide. So, for adiabatic mixing process, we have this ratio G1 by G2 equal to H3 minus H2 divided by H1 minus H3. So, G1 equal to 1 kilogram, G2 equal to 2 kilogram, H3 is the unknown. So, H3 minus H2 is 60 divided by H1 101 minus 6, H3 is unknown. Substituting the values, so solving this equation, H3 equal to 73.7 kilojoules per kilogram. And similarly, we have the for specific humidity, G1 by G2 equal to W3 minus W2 divided by W1 minus W3. So, we substitute again G1 1, G2 2, W3 is the unknown. So, minus 15.5 divided by 24 minus W3 equal to solving this equation, cross multiply and solve this equation. So, we will get W3 equal to 18.3 grams per kg. Now, we go back 18.3 grams per kg. So, for 18.3, you draw an horizontal line. And then here the temperature is 26.5 degree Celsius. So, the final temperature is 26.5 degree Celsius for this specific humidity, for this enthalpy 73.7 and W3 equal to 18.3 grams per kg. So, you carefully use the cyclometric chart. Using the cyclometric chart, it is very easy to solve the problem. So, for convenience, I repeat the problem again. This is the second condition. So, T2 equal to 20 degree Celsius, dew point temperature is 20 degree Celsius. First, you draw a line, locate the point, and second, initial condition T1 equal to 40 degree Celsius and relative humidity is 50%. Locate this point and draw the vertical line. Now, this is the process line. 1 to 2 is the process line. then you note down the properties, calculate H3 and W3, then you find the temperature. Locate the point 3 and then find the temperature, which is 26.5 degree Celsius. That is the answer to the problem. So, calculate the temperature and specific humidity of the mixer. So, specific humidity of the mixer is 18.3 grams per kg and temperature is 26.5 degree Celsius. And we take another example, 1 kg of air at 35 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity is mixed with 2 kg of air, 20 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 30 degree Celsius dew point temperature. Calculate the specific humidity of the mixer. So, this is the given data. So, G1 1 kg, G2 2 kg, T1 35 degree Celsius, Phi1 60%, T2 20 degree Celsius and dew point temperature is 13 degree Celsius. You take the psychrometric chart and you locate the first point which is 35 degree Celsius and 60% relative humidity. You locate the second point which is 20 degree Celsius and 13 degree dew point temperature. So, dew point temperature you have to read horizontally. So, this is 13 degree Celsius. You draw horizontal line, you will get the point here. Now, this is point 2. 1 and 2 is the process line. Now, we take the properties. So, H1 equal to 91 kilojoules per kilogram. H2 equal to 45 kilojoules per kilogram. So, H1 is 91, H2 is 45 and W1 equal to 22 kilojoules grams per kg and W2 equal to 9.5 grams per kg. Now, you go to the next slide and calculate the properties. So, the same equations we have to use, G1 by G2 equal to H3 minus H2. This is obtained just by mass balance. You can refer to lecture number 1002 for the discussion. So, this is just mass balance, you will get this equation, G1 by G2 equal to H3 minus H2 divided by H1 minus H3. Substituting the values and solving the equations, will get H3 equal to 60.3 kilojoules per kilogram. Similarly, for specific humidity, G1 by G2 equal to W3 minus W2 divided by W1 minus W3. So, again substitute the values, known values, W3 minus 9.5 divided by 22 minus W3. Cross multiply, 22 minus W3 equal to 2 times of W3 plus 19. So, 3W3, rearrange the terms, 3W3 equal to 41. So, W3 equal to 13.7 grams per kg. Now, using this value, we can go back to the previous chart and find out the temperature here. So, we locate the chart point number 3 based on the calculated value and find out the temperature, and the find out the temperature is 25.5 degree Celsius. So, again using this psychrometric chart is very easy to solve the problem. Otherwise, you have to remember all the equations and solve the problem. So, using psychrometric chart, it is easy, but only problem is you have to carefully locate and take the values, the accurate results from the chart. That is very important. Reading the chart is very important. Next problem, 23. If the airflow of 1800 meter cube per hour at 35 degree Celsius and relative humidity of 50% is mixed with another air stream of 2100 meter cube per hour of air whose both dry and wet bulb temperatures are 20 degree Celsius. If the pressure is constant at 1 atmosphere, calculate the dry bulb temperature, relative humidity, specific humidity and the volume flow rate of the mixer. So, we have to calculate all the values for the mixer final condition. So, this is from the November 2018 question paper. And we take the psychrometric chart and the given data. Volume V1 equal to 1800 meter cube per hour, volume V2 is 2100 meter cube per hour, T1 is 35 degree Celsius and the Phi1 is 50%, T2 is dry bulb temperature is 20 degree Celsius and wet bulb temperature is also 20 degree Celsius. Locate the point. So, this is the second temperature. So, 20 degree Celsius and wet bulb temperature 20 degree Celsius, and this is the first point. So, 35 degree Celsius and 50% relative humidity. So, you connect these two and this is the first point, this is the first point and this is the second point, initial condition and final condition. Now, we take the properties before you mark here and we will take the properties. H1 equal to 82.5 kilojoules per kilogram, H2 equal to 59.5 kilojoules per kilogram. W1, here it is, W1 equal to 18.3 grams per kg, W2 equal to 15.3 grams per kg. So, V1 specific volume here 0.9 meter cube per kg and V2 is 0.854 meter cube per kg. Now, we go back to the calculation, mass flow rate of air. So, G1 equal to V1 by specific capital volume divided by the specific volume. So, volume equal to 1800 divided by 3600. This is given meter cube per hour. So, 1800 divided by 3600 divided by specific volume 0.9. So, G1 equal to 0.55 kgs per second. And G2 mass flow rate in the second channel, second fluid. V2 by volume divided by specific volume. So, 2100 divided by 3600 into 0.854 is equal to 0.68 kilograms per second. Now, we calculate the for adiabatic mixing process, we have the G1 by G2 equal to W3 minus W2 divided by W1 minus W3. So, G1 we calculated 0.55 and G2 we calculated 0.68 equal to W3 minus 15.3 divided by W1 is 18.3 minus W3 and the cross multiply 0.55 into 18.3 10.065, 0.55 into W3 equal to 0.55 W3 and the cross multiply 0.68 W3 minus 0.68 into 15.3 equal to 10.404. So, rearrange the terms. So, 0.68 plus 0.55 equal to 1.23 W3 equal to 20.469. So, W3 equal to 16.6 grams per kg. And using this value 16.6 grams per kg, you come back to the chart. So, this is 16.6. So, correspond to this point, locate the point here and read the temperature, relative humidity, all the properties. So, for the calculated W3, you draw the horizontal line. This is 0.3. Then from 0.3, you can read relative humidity, the temperature and the specific volume. That is what in the next calculation. Now, from the psychrometric chart, at a specific humidity W3 equal to 16.6 grams per kg, dry bulb temperature is 26 degrees Celsius, relative humidity is 75% and specific volume of the air V3 equal to 0.872 meter cube per kg. And the volume flow rate of the mixer V3, capital V3 equal to M3 into V3. So, mass equal to 1.23. So, total mass equal to G1 plus G2, which is 1.23. 1.23 into 0.872 equal to 1.07 meter cube per second or 3861.2 meter cube per hour. That is the volume flow rate and these are all the properties of the mixer. This is the answer to the problem. And example number 24 from November 2019 question paper. So, 1 kg of air at 313 Kelvin dry bulb temperature and 50% relative humidity is mixed with 2 kg of air at 298 Kelvin dry bulb temperature and dew point temperature. So, calculate the temperature and the specific humidity of the mixture. And write down the given data. So, you take the psychrometric chart, write down the given data. So, G1 mass flow rate of first stream is 1 kilogram, second stream 2 kilogram. Initial temperature of the first steam is 313 Kelvin, which is 40 degrees Celsius and 51 equal to 50%. For the second steam, temperature is, dry bulb temperature is 25 degrees Celsius and dew point temperature is also 25 degrees Celsius. Now, this is the second point and this is the first point. So, second point 25 degrees Celsius, dry bulb temperature and dew point temperature. First point 40 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 50% relative humidity. You connect these two and you locate the point. So, this is 0.1. So, corresponding enthalpy H1 we have to calculate 97.5 kilojoules per kilogram and this is 0.2. The corresponding enthalpy is 76.5 kilojoules per kilogram and here W1 equal to 22.5. W1 equal to 22.5 and W2 here W2 equal to 20 grams per kg. And now for adiabatic mixing process, we take G1 by G2 equal to H3 minus H2 divided by H1 minus H3. So, substitute the known values. So, G1 is 1, G2 is 2, H3 is unknown, H2 equal to 76.5, H1 is 97.5, H3 is the unknown, cross multiply and calculate H3 equal to 83.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And similarly for the specific humidity, G1 by G2 equal to W3 minus W2 divided by W1 minus W3. So, again 1 by 2 equal to W3 is the unknown minus W2 equal to 20 grams per kg and W1 is 22.5 grams per kg minus W3 and the cross multiply and calculate the answer W3 equal to 20.8 grams per kg and the corresponding temperature is 27.5 degree Celsius. So that is what the temperature. So locating the, for the you calculate the value, you locate the point and find the temperature, which is 27.5 degree Celsius. Then example number 25. So air at 20 degree Celsius, 40% relative humidity is mixed adiabatically with the air at 40 degree Celsius and 40% relative humidity in the ratio of 1 kilogram former and 2 kilogram later on dry basis. Find the final condition of the air. So this is from May 2018 and May 2017 question paper. So first steam 1 kg of air, second steam is 2 kg of air. First case temperature is 20 degree Celsius and relative humidity is 40%. Second case, temperature is 40 degree Celsius and relative humidity is again 40%. Now look at the second point, first point 20 degree Celsius and 40% relative humidity. Second point 40 degree Celsius and 40% relative humidity. You connect these two. So this is 1 and 2. And we can take the enthalpy H1 equal to 35 kilojoules per kilogram, H2 equal to 88 kilojoules per kilogram, W1 equal to 6 grams per kg. And W2 equal to 19 grams per kg. So here it is 19. So here it is 6. And here it is 35. And here it is 98. All the values are taken now. Now you go for adiabatic mixing process. So calculate the enthalpy. So G1 by G2 equal to H3 minus H2 divided by H1 minus H3. You can read. It is very repeatedly the same formula we are using for solving the problem. Unknown we have to calculate, H3 we have to calculate. So H3 is calculated as 69.3 kilojoules per kg, and similarly enthalpy, specific humidity also we have to calculate. You take the equation, substitute the known values and calculate W3 equal to 14.7 grams per kg. So the final condition, so the question is here, we have to calculate the final condition of the air. So final condition is specific humidity is 14.7 grams per kg and final enthalpy is 69.3 kilojoules per kilogram. That is the final condition. Okay, the calculations are clear. Right. Next problem. Example number 26 here, so from the May 2013 question paper. So two streams of moist air, one having the rate of 3 kilograms per second at 30 degree Celsius and 30% relative humidity, other having a flow rate of 2 kilograms per second at 35 degree Celsius, 85% relative humidity, gets mixed adiabatically. Determine specific humidity, partial pressure of water vapor after mixing. So say take Cp equal to 1.86 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So write down the given data. G1 is 3 kilogram, G2 is 2 kilogram, T1 equal to 30 degree Celsius, phi 1 is 30%, T2 equal to 35 degree Celsius and phi 2 equal to 85%. And this problem is very difficult to solve by psychrometric chart, because the values are not accommodated within the psychrometric chart. So we calculate the value. So we calculate one by one. So finally we have to calculate the specific humidity and the partial pressure of the mixer. So from steam table, so we have the temperature T1 equal to 30 degree Celsius. So corresponding to this, the saturation pressure is 0.04242 bar. T2 equal to 35 degree Celsius, the corresponding saturation pressure is 0.056622 bar. Now we calculate the partial pressure. We know the specific humidity for the first steam and the second steam. So partial pressure of water vapor for the first steam and the second steam, PW1 equal to PS1 into phi 1, this 0.04242 into 0.3 equal to 0.0127 bar, and the partial pressure of water vapor for the second stream, PW2 equal to PS2 into phi 2, which is 0.05622 into 0.85 equal to 0.048 bar. Now we calculate the specific humidity. Once you know the partial pressure of water vapor, you can calculate the specific humidity. So W1 equal to 0.622 into PW1 by P minus PW1. So P we take atmospheric pressure, so 1.01325 bar. So the 0.62 into 0.0127 divided by 1.01325 minus 0.0127 equal to 0.0079 kg per kg of air. And W2 equal to the same formula, substitute numerical values, 0.622 into 0.048 divided by 1.01325 minus 0.048 equal to 0.031 kg per kg of air. Now we have the specific humidity W1 and W2. Now we use the equation for adiabatic mixing. So G1 by G2 equal to W3 minus W2 divided by W1 minus W3. So G1 equal to 3 kilogram, G2 equal to 2 kilogram. So W3 is the unknown minus 0.031 divided by 0.0079 minus W3. Cross multiply, so 3 into 0.0079 0.0237 minus 3W3 equal to 2W3 minus 2 into 0.031 equal to 0.062. Rearrange the constant, so 3 plus 2, 5W3 equal to 0.0857 and W3 equal to 0.0171 kg per kg of air. So specific humidity of the mixer is 0.0171 kg per kg of air and the partial pressure of air after mixing. So we know the specific humidity. So from specific humidity we can calculate the partial pressure. So W3 equal to 0.622 PW3 by P minus PW3. So here PW3 is the unknown. So W3 equal to 0.0171 equal to 0.622 into PW3 divided by 1.01325 minus PW2. So do the simple mathematical calculation. So rearrange the terms and find out what is W3. So PW3 equal to 0.0278 bar. So the question here, what is the specific humidity of the mixer and the partial pressure of air after mixing? So specific humidity is 0.0171 kg per kg of air. And partial pressure of air after mixing is PW3 equal to 0.0278 bar. So we stop here. So that is the end of the psychrometric. So these are all the problems. These are all the books I referred for preparing the slides. You can also use the books for your additional information. And you can write to my mail ID for all your questions or queries. And you please subscribe the channel. So I have uploaded more than 100 YouTube videos on the thermal engineering subjects like heat and mass transfer, gas dynamics, engineering thermodynamics, and I solved gate questions and uploaded the solution also using through the YouTube video. You subscribe, you will get more updated videos for your better learning. Thank you very much for listening and we will meet again.